Hello everybody, how is everyone doing? Welcome back to another tutorial. Today I want to show you how to create this text treatment for your After Effects project, or any text you want to use in your After Effects project. This is actually a little bit of a fake metallic bevel appearance, and it's actually quite easy to achieve in After Effects. You just need to know what you're looking for and what to do with the various plugins that are available inside After Effects. So this has been done without any third-party plugins. It's all created in using just the default settings. You know, you can see we can move this around, etc. But I'm just going to start from scratch and show you how to do it in relatively short amount of time. So let's begin by losing this project. See you later. Create a new comp. As always, make sure you name your comp. Black matte. And I'm going to create a text object. And that's black actually, because I was busy messing around with these character settings. Let's make it white to start off with. And I'm going to make it really, really large. So there's your Fruit Movie font. The one thing you do need is actually a grunge texture. And this grunge texture is actually key to this entire process. So this is a grunge map I used, I took the photo of my garage floor. So you can go ahead and take a photo of, you know, something that's relatively cleanish, or you can head over the internet and download a lot of grunge textures all over the web. Otherwise I can just, I'll link down this file and you can grab it. So we're gonna put that grunge texture inside and just make it nice and small. Now the next thing we're going to do is turn this to have a track mat, and we're going to use Luma mat. You can use Alpha mat if you want, it doesn't matter with the text on top, but I'm just going to use Luma mat. Turn this to a blue, and now I'm going to duplicate the text file and open this up and just solo it. Now this next step is quite important. We need this text to be black because we're actually going to add a comp mode, which is an add mode later down the track. So if we turn this black, and I'll show you what we're going to do next, we are going to add a bevel alpha. Drag, drop. Now by default that's a little bit too low. We're going to set the intensity up. Just pull up all the way to maximum, and the edge thickness, we're going to just do it, you know, just bring it up a little bit, not too much. And change this to a orange color, or slightly orange. Now, what we're going to do next, I'm going to turn this off. Okay, so with this on, we are going to turn the mode to add, and we've actually composited that bevel effect onto the bottom grunge map. Now, we're going to duplicate this top bevel alpha text again, like so, and we are going to reverse the direction of where that light is going, and change the color to a blue. Now in general, whenever you have a 3D text, you tend to have a bit of ambient light. This kind of simulates the ambient light, you know, marginally, and it gives it a nice, you know, open air kind of a feel. Now the next thing we're going to do is actually crush the grunge map a lot, because it's a little bit too light and undetailed. We're just going to pull that down and pull that up. You know, your typical S-curve. We want a lot of contrast with this. Okay. Now already you can see that we have a very, you know, pretty close result. We're going to do a lot of tweaks in a minute. But that's how easy it is to begin, you know, setting up your general style of it. So that's your text file right there, ready for tweaking. So we want this to be a nice golden color. So we're going to go to red and pull the red up a little bit. Now we want to pull the blue down just ever so slightly. So we have that nice golden color, probably not too much because we don't want it to, you know, wash out. And I might bring red down a tad. And I may put the green up a little bit just to bring that yellow out. You know, we don't want it to be too red. We do want it to be quite golden. And now we can do a bit of tweaking. So back in these two layers on top, we have, you know, basically those two bevel edges that we've messed around. We're going to just adjust the thickness. Okay. probably 5.5. By the way, guys, I'm doing this by eye. I'm not really, you know, finding a perfect value. I'm just looking at it and going, okay, that looks good. So it's quite subjective. It's up to you what you want to do. Now I've got a nice, decent font. Before I do go on, I'm going to just add a bit of background, background color, because the background is boring. Very, very simple. Orange solid. Bit of masking. Let's bring that up a little bit, and I may actually pull that down because I don't want it to be too harsh. I'm going to duplicate this. So this orange solid now will go all the way on top to give it the top highlight, and I'm going to change this to a blue. As probably most people already know, blue and yellow have quite a nice, you know, contrasting effect. But that's, you know, up for debate. It's quite subjective. Now we have a decent background. We're going to do one more thing. Add a bit of glow onto the orange. And adjust these settings ever so slightly until we get a result that we are happy with. Now I'm going to just change the color to make it a little bit warmer. Again, a lot of this is quite just pretty much about guessing and checking. You know, find something that works for you. There's no hard and fast rule about it. Keep adjusting, play around with the settings until you are satisfied with a result that you think works very well. And one last thing, I may actually just change the background color to be a little bit of a darker color. There you have it. And if you like, you can actually add a adjustment layer. This is optional, by the way, but I like to just add a little bit of a extra pizzazz to my font, and we'll put a glow on top. But this time we are going to make it a, just increase the glow radius, and we're going to turn it to a vertical. So we get that little bit of sparkly effect. You can use other plugins, by the way, with this, and we're going to turn the glow threshold up and the glow intensity down. Just to bring that extra niceness to it. There you have it, guys. Very simple metallic font style, I should say. It's quite easy to do and quite easy to create. Just don't forget to utilize a grunge map to give it a little bit of extra texture. And I mean, let me know if these tutorials are, you know, being useful or if they're not really helping you. I'll do my best to answer any questions and add extra tutorials as we go. And obviously, over time, you'll get better. I mean, I would have started the same way as well. I had no idea what I was doing, and then eventually I just started getting, you know, everything becomes quite normal. Pretty much second nature as you go on and practice. So there you have it, guys. Let me know your thoughts. Feel free to comment and leave some feedback, and I'll see you next time.